Good morning, children. Today we will be doing with unit 3 one lesson. And what is the lesson's name? Discover a Footprint by Robinson Crusoe. Here the author has given his adventure. Now we will learn why it is written here, discover a footprint. I will be reading the first page and then I will be explaining. Just take out your textbook so that it will be easy for you to understand what I am trying to read here. One day, when I was going towards my boat, I was surprised to see the footprint of a man on the sand. I stood amazed. I listened. I looked around me. I could neither hear or see anything. I went up higher to look down. I went up to the shore and down the shore, but it was no good. I could find no other footprint but that one. I went to it again to see if there were any more footprints and to tell if it has been my imagination. But I was not mistaken, for they were exactly the prints of a foot, toes, heel, every part of a foot. I could not imagine how it came there. I stayed a long time thinking, but became more and more confused. So this, the first page, the explanation goes like this. When this author, Robinson, was the first, when you just read that first paragraph, above that there is a some quoted or just clouded lines over there. It is told that he was traveling and when his ship broke down, he just landed out on one island and was living there in an island with no one. That means he was living in that whole island all alone for many years. So what happened? One day when he was going towards his my boat, see, my boat means his boat. That means he was living there for years. So he was surviving on the fish and the plants there. So when he was just moving towards his boat, what he found? He found a footprint of a man on the sand. See, when we go to a seashore and when we just walk there without our shoes or sandals, what our footprints are out there on the sand. So here also, when the author was just towards his boat, he saw a footprint and he was so amazed. He was so confused. He started looking here and there. See, the third and the fourth line is written here. He could not hear anything or he could not see anything. That means he was just, when he found the footprints were there on the sand, he just looked around and there was no one. He just tried to listen. Is there anyone talking there? Or just tried to see, is there anyone there? But there was nothing. So another, it was but he was still confused. So he just moved forward, and what he saw there, he just went up the hills to look up from the hills, and is there anyone there? Or he just climbed down there and he found no one there. So again he just went down and he just imagined, is there anyone else? So he just found a footprint that healed the foot. See, when you walk on the sand, the old footprints are there on the sand. So he was so confused and he was so in amaze and he was thinking who it might be there. Because for the years this author was staying all alone in this island, and all of a sudden he found a footprint. Now children, when we just turn to the next page, here the story goes like this now. At last, I returned home very frightened, looking behind me after every two or three steps, mistaking every bush and tree to be a man. When I came into my cave, which I called my castle, I ran inside it as if I was being chased, and chased, I do not remember whether I used the ladder or went in my this stanza is telling us that he was so frightened that he just ran very fast. He was so frightened because when he found that no one was there on that area where he was standing, he was just searching here and there. And what he found, he was so frightened that he just ran. He just wanted to run back to his home. And the second line still is looking behind every two or three steps. That means whenever he was just running, he just was looking back that is there anyone who is coming behind? And he was mistaking that every bush and a tree to be a man. He was so frightened. See, when you look down in your picture there, you can see that he was so running very fast, and he was thinking that there might be someone hiding in the bushes or in the tree. And he was so frightened that he just went inside his castle. Castle is a king, na, where the kings are living. That does not mean that he was living in a big palace, a small cave, because he was there all alone for a number of years. So he felt that his cave is like a palace for him, and he just went inside his rock as soon as possible. Now in the third page, see in the second page, what was written there, that he was so frightened that he was just running back to his home. That means when he was supposed to go out with his boat for fishing, he was so frightened to look out the footprints there. He thought that someone might be there in his island. He was so frightened that he ran very fast to his cave. Now when we come to the third page of this lesson, it's written that inside the rock, which I called the door, I ran for cover faster than any animal could run. I did not sleep that night. The more I thought about what I had seen, the more frightened I became. I thought it would be one of the savages of the mainland who had wandered out to the sea in a small boat. Luckily, I was not on the shore at that time. But what if he had seen my boat? If he had seen the boat, he would have realized that someone lived on the island and could soon return with others to kill and eat me. So this paragraph, what is it telling that when the author saw a footprint, he was so frightened that he did not went for his fishing there. He left the boat on the shore and he just came back to his cave. See the rock. See in the olden time, the people where the those people were living in the cave does not have the door, wooden doors. They used to roll a rock over the cave in the form of a door. He was so frightened that the day he could not sleep. But he was just thinking that whatever happened over there, whoever might be a savage. See, one word is there. What do you mean by that? It's a wild, you can say a primitive man who can eat others. So here, he was so frightened, he was thinking that might be this primitive man of some other main island would be wandering in his boat. He was just moving here and there in his hand. He might have seen, he had just seen the author's boat, and he might be getting an idea that this island someone is living. And see, the author is having so much of confusion in his mind. He was just thinking more and more. Why? Because he was so frightened that this primitive man would go back to his own island and bring some other men so that he can hunt him. So all this disturbance was there in his thought, and he was so frightened that he did not left his cave for days. And so I lay fearful for many days and prayed for protection. In doing so, I was much comforted and began going to investigate. But even now, as I went forward, I looked behind me frequently because I was still very frightened. However, as I went about for 2 or 3 days and saw nothing, I began to bolder. I decided to go down to the shore again and examine the footprints once more. I decided to measure it with my own footmark. So what this paragraph said that he was so frightened that for many days he was inside his cave, and he was just praying to God, or he was just inside, he was so frightened. in that he did not even went out. So for many days he was still inside his cave and was praying to God for the protection. That was just telling that it might be a wild man who came there to hunt him. So he just felt. After 2-3 days he felt a little bit of relaxed and he was just thinking for himself and what he was doing. He told to himself that why can't I just go out and find out. So he just went out, but still he was having a fear inside his mind that might be someone there. But after he just went 2 or 3 days regularly, went to the shore and was looking, he found no one. That means in that situation, he felt that a little bit of boldness came inside him. So he just decided that the next day he will be definitely going out to investigate. Investigate means to find out whose footmark it was. And he was just ready for the next day to go out and to just investigate that whether the footmark was his or someone else. So now when we come to the last paragraph of this page, all we can see a conclusion thing. What is there? I am reading it. See, and just focus in your textbook. As I came closer to the footprint, I realized that it would not be my footprint because I had not come to this part of the beach since a long time. Secondly, as I placed my foot alongside that footprint, it seemed larger than my own. My fear returned. I went home again, believing that there was someone there. The island was inhabited. Now, what does this paragraph tell us? That when he found that he became a little bit bold, he just went out to investigate and he just came down to the footprint. He just examined there very carefully and a conscious of thing that came into his mind was that this footprint is not his. The first reason of why he's telling is that he just believing because that particular area where the footprint was there, that particular area the author did not care. And second thing, what he's just thinking is that when he just measured, when he see when the footprint are there, we can just measure with when the sand is wet, we can just place down your leg aside. And when he just put there his foot, the footprint that he has seen on the sand was larger in size. And knowing this, he again got frightened. And what happened? He ran back to his home and believing that this island, which he was living for many years, according to him, he was living here for this island many years and no one was there. And he thought that after imagining and after having an investigation that the footprint is not his footprint, he believed that now that this island was inhabited. See, inhabited is a word that tells us that some other people or someone else is also living in this island. Hope you have understood the story. Try to read it once again and write down the textual meaning that is there in the next page in your notebook. And along with this video, I am sending a textual exercise that is there in the PDF. So you have to read it, the lessons once again. Write down the meaning in your notebook and the textual exercise that I am writing down in this PDF below, you have to just copy in your textbook.